There was no choice. I had to do as Catherine asked and meet her in Taipei on the 18th. Tom understood my position and helped me make the necessary arrangements. Telling our boss, Mr. Reynolds, was not easy, but fortunately, he was able to find a replacement. It was decided that I would fly with the IT team to Hong Kong, and from there I would continue on to Taipei, arriving on the morning of the 18th. A reservation was made for me at the Grand Hotel. Everything went smoothly, and at the Hong Kong airport, I said goodbye to my colleagues and then boarded a flight to Taipei. The plane was fairly empty, so I settled myself in an aisle seat and immediately closed my eyes. I was exhausted from the long flight from New York. Suddenly, a voice interrupted my nap.
Excuse me, can I get through? My seat is next to the window.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Here.
Thank you. I'm sorry to have disturbed you. Thank goodness I just made it.
Just in the nick of time.
I had an urgent phone call from London just as I was about to leave my apartment.
Funny how those things happen when you're extremely busy and in a rush.
I know. My boss had a few questions, and of course he gave me some more work.
And your work is?
Oh, I'm a journalist with Fox News, but I'm based in Hong Kong.
Now that sounds exciting. Do you enjoy it?
Love it. Especially documentary work. That's why I'm going to Taiwan.
To write a documentary?
Yes. I'm gathering material for a program on the Dutch occupation of Taiwan in the 17th century.
That should make an interesting program.
I hope so. Anyway, what's your story? What do you do?
I'm an IT specialist for global applications.
Really? What area do you specialize in?
Creating websites. I came to speak at the Hong Kong Internet Expo.
Wow, you must be some kind of expert. But I thought the Internet Expo was being held this week, starting tomorrow.
It is. But I received an urgent message to meet my sister in Taipei.
Does she live in Taiwan?
She's an anthropologist working on Orchid Island.
Sounds like somebody I'd like to meet.
Well, maybe you can. Where are you staying?
At the Grand Hotel.
That's a coincidence. So am I. We can take a taxi together.
Good. By the way, my name's Victoria. Victoria Crawford.
And I'm Philip Hamilton.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Philip Hamilton.
Victoria, or Vicky as she liked to be called, and I talked the entire flight. I forgot how tired I was. I enjoyed our conversation immensely. And the next thing I knew, we were preparing to land at Taipei International Airport.